Hello, I'm Priscilla Connors from the University of North Texas. We're here today at the home of chef instructor Jody Duryea to see the effects of time, temperature, and pH on edible plant pigments. These edible plant pigments are phytochemicals, or non-essential substances found in our foods that give us health benefits beyond those of the basic nutrients. Hi, Chef Duryea. Thanks for inviting us into your home.
Thanks, Dr. Connors. It's a pleasure having you here.
Would you like to tell us what you plan to do with the vegetables today?
Sure. We're going to start with green vegetables, and that's your chlorophyll. And we just have some examples of those vegetables. So this is just your basic jalapeno, of course. And then you have your green bell peppers. They're zucchini. Now, zucchini has both the chlorophyll on the outside, and then inside it's white, so it would be a flavonoid.
So a multi-purpose plant.
It's a multi-purpose phytochemical bonanza. And this is your kale, and again, this has both your chlorophyll and your carotenoids as pigments. Even though the dominant one is chlorophyll that you see, but when you're actually underneath that layer of chlorophyll is the orangey pigments, the yellow pigments. When you cook kale, you always want to remove the stem. That stem is very woody, lots of cellulose, very chewy. So when you take, you want to just cook the green part of it. And then we have here some really lovely collard greens. And again, your collard greens are great examples of chlorophyll.
It has really large leaves.
It's huge, and you always want to chop your leaves up. And again, you want to take the stem off. So the best way to do that is just strip the leaves right off of it.
That doesn't damage the leaf when you just strip it like that?
And you can see how it's just really stringy. And as you cook it, it becomes even stringier. So this is the part you want. And again, you want to just, you can tear it up or you can cut it up before you cook it. And then over here we have some fresh beets. And these are starting to fall apart. But the beets are an example of your flavonoids, your red pigment, purple pigment vegetables. But the greens are wonderful to cook with. They're great sauteed. They're also really good when they're really little as a salad green. So very nice, good source of calcium.
Is there only a specific time of the year that the greens are available, or can you get them all the time?
You can usually get green beets most of the year. They're actually grow better in cool weather, and they're usually harvested around in the cooler temperatures. Not solid winter, but definitely spring and fall, depending on when they were planted.
Okay.
And then today, what we're going to use for our demonstration are sugar snap peas. And sugar snap peas are real sweet, they're real crunchy, you can eat the whole thing. The only thing you want to try to remove with the sugar snap pea is the string that goes around it, because that string, again, a little chewy, so when you're eating them, they tend to just get caught in your teeth.
Is there a specific time of year that you get fresh sugar snap peas?
Well, most of the time, they used to be considered an early summer, late spring.
Okay.
Vegetable, but nowadays you can get them most of the year.
Does it take very long to cook them?
No, your sugar snap peas usually cook within a minute or two. You want to start with boiling water.
Why would you want to do that?
That way the heat comes back up quickly. If you start them in cold water, by the time they get to a boil, they're going to have lost a lot of their pigment. And one of the primary aims when we're cooking is to retain as much color as possible, because that signifies you're retaining vitamins.
Okay.
These sugar snap peas are going to be used to demonstrate time and pH. The green vegetables in general, you always want to cook in a full boiling pot of water, and you want a large amount of water relative to the amount of
vegetables. Would you do that?
So again, the more water you have when you have it up at boiling, when you put the vegetables in, it's going to come much faster up to a boil.
All right.
And the idea is that you're going to retain as much chlorophyll, or the green pigment, as possible.
Okay.
And what we're going to demonstrate use, what we're going to use to demonstrate this, are two pots of boiling water. So what we're going to do first is check our water and make sure it's neutral. So I put the test strip just for a second, and you can see 7 pH, which is neutral. From here, I'll take the vinegar, and we're going to do about 1 ounce of vinegar per quart of water. And hopefully, turns to about a 5 pH, which is a nice acid level. And then we take baking soda, and I'm going to use about a tablespoon of baking soda, and again, a quart of water. And that comes out to about a 9 pH, so a nice alkali solution. So from here, I'm going to put in a good handful of the sugar snap peas. And I'll start the timer for 2 minutes. Hopefully, they should come back up to a boil very quickly. From that point, you already can see how initially when they enter that boiling water, they turn a nice bright green. If you compare it to the ones before they were cooked. With chlorophyll, generally what should happen with an alkali is they actually turn a nice brighter green. And there are some people that will use that little bit of baking soda when they wash their lettuces to make it a brighter green. The downside to it is that the alkali will actually start to break down the fibers in the vegetable and they become mushy and soggy. With your green vegetables in an acidic water, what tends to happen to the chlorophyll is it leaches the chlorophyll out and they start to turn grayish green. 2 minutes, I'm going to set it for an additional 6, and I'll take some of so you can see that the alkali stayed a nice bright green. The ice, we put the vegetables into an ice bath to stop the cooking quickly, so this shocks them and that will, and removes the heat quickly so that the heat doesn't continue to cook them. You can see the immediate color difference. This is with the alkali and this is with the acid. The alkali are much brighter. And you can also see in terms of the firmness. These are softer, more bendable. They're not going to be as crunchy. These have a little bit more body to them, because acid tends to make fibers stronger. Alkali breaks them down. So this is about 6 minutes into the boiling of the vegetables. You can see again that with the acid, the green is becoming paler. There's a little bit of around the edges, there's a yellowing of the vegetables, or almost that kind of khaki color starting to form. And then over here with the baking soda, the alkali, they're still real bright green, but their shape is getting a little softer. The water itself is changing color. It's becoming a much more yellower color, either from the baking soda being heated or from the actual chlorophyll getting into the water. So that was 8 minutes. And I'll take, you can see as I'm taking it out that they're really falling apart, slimy almost. the baking soda is breaking down the fibers and making it. And then with the acid, they're becoming that kind of olive gray, but they still hold their shape well. So here you have your alkali, and you can almost see how slimy they've become. They've really broken down, but they have retained their really bright green color. So chlorophyll, definitely, baking soda helps retain chlorophyll as they cook, but unfortunately the effect on the fiber is not pleasant. And then with the acid, when you cook a green vegetable in an acid, you can see the distinctly olive color that you create with that. The fiber itself stays very firm.
We've been testing the effect of cooking medium pH on chlorophyll, a green plant pigment. Here are 5 samples of snow peas that demonstrate the effect, from front to back. In the very front are snow peas that are raw and uncooked. In the second row, on the left, the snow peas have been cooked for 2 minutes in an acid environment. On the right, they were cooked for 2 minutes in a basic environment. In the third row are snow peas on the left that were cooked for 8 minutes in an acid environment, on the right, cooked for 8 minutes in a basic environment. This demonstrates the color change that chlorophyll experiences when exposed to an acid, which makes it drab olive green, and a base or alkaline, which helps it remain a bright green.